Hello student, in this video we discuss the next part of resource economics. Here in this we going to deal with the resource depletion point and causes for the same. So depletion is very important concept, so you have to understand it properly. And about externalities in agriculture means positive and negative externalities. Here, important issues in economics and management of common property resources of land, water, pasture, and forest resources that we have to discuss. Okay, so we start with the first point. What is resource depletion? Resource depletion is an economic term referring to the exhaustion of raw material within a region. Resource depletion is most commonly used in reference to farming, fishing, mining, and fossil fuels. Causes of resource depletion. Okay, so overconsumption, excessive or unnecessary use of resource. Then non-equitable distribution of resource. Overpopulation, slash and burn agricultural practices currently occurring in many developing countries. Technological and industrial development, erosion, irrigation, mining for oil and minerals, aquifer depletion, forestry, pollution or contamination of resources. So these are the different causes of resource depletion. Okay, due to this particular factors, the resources decreases in that particular region or exhausted. Now we see the next concept, externalities. The allocation of resources to productive use result from consumers and producers making decision with the aim of maximizing satisfaction and profit respectively. Private cost and private benefits are taken into account in deciding purchase and organizing production. Social cost and benefit include cost and benefits of consumer and producer, but also cost borne by those who are not participating in that particular market. These are known as external cost and benefits or external benefits, or we can call togetherly it as a externalities. External cost and benefits can arise through both consumption and production process. From a sustainable development perspective, external costs are most significant and arguable account for the failure of individual communities and nations to follow a sustainable path. Now we see the type of externalities. Here, first one, negative externality. When economic agents not directly involved, then negative externalities can exist, such as pollution. Okay, so pollution is the example of negative externalities. Positive externalities in production means that social cost is less than private cost and more of goods should be produced than will occur in a free market. So if the cost is less, social cost is less, okay, so there will be the less depletion or less exhaustion of resources. So that is the point comes under positive externalities. Efficient market. A market is said to be efficient if marginal price and marginal cost are equal. If not, then a market is failure. So marginal price, so it's a difference between original price and original cost. So if these two points are equal, then in economics we can call it as a efficient market. External cost, this shows the negative effects of externality, that is pollution or industry. And external benefits, this shows the positive or beneficial effects of externality. For example, the industry supplying smallpox vaccination is assumed to be selling in a competitive market. So whatever the industries who supply vaccines, so that comes under which externalities? External benefits to the society. So that is the example. Okay. Now, major issues in the use of natural resources related with productivity, equity, and sustainability. So sustainability means the word sustainability is derived from Latin word tenure, to hold, sus means up. The most widely quoted definition of sustainability and sustainable development, that of Brundtland Commission of the United Nations on March 1987. What is the definition they gave? Sustainable development is development that meets the need of the present without compromising the ability of future generation to meet their own needs. Environmental, social, and economic demands are the three pillars of sustainability. Okay, which are the three pillars of sustainability? Environmental, social, and economic demands. Okay, resource productivity. What is resource productivity? Is the quantity of goods or service that is obtained through the expenditure of unit resource. Whatever you done expenditure on different resources, that output we get, that is called as, that concept is called as resource productivity. This can be expressed in monetary terms as the monetary yield per unit resource. Resource productivity and resource intensity are key concepts used in sustainability measurement. The sustainability objective is to maximize resource productivity while minimizing resource intensity. So this is the objective of sustainability. So automatically your resource productivity depends on sustainability. Okay. Now equity issues. Equity is the third, third major issues. Okay. So equity issues, K parameters and indicators we just take into consideration. The majority of the people would be deprived in terms of low welfare level despite their hard work. Okay, the unfair access to public infrastructure, facilities and resources could occur. This is related with the public infrastructure, facilities and services, unfair access. So that is called as equity failure. That is, failure to guarantee intra and intergenerational equity would cause deep inequality and unsustainability. Natural resources may be so exploited that there would be sustainable use of that resources. Negative externalities of economic activities could create serious threat to the environment. So we have to focus on minimizing such type of negative externality. Okay, thank you.